or they try to.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
The Alpine's bumping, but I need the volume higher.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus! Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
Turn me on till I earn them on, let's get it on.
Stop banging on the damn furnace. You hear me now? This is the last time.
What up, though? It's your boy Lo Gross, also known as Big Papa Skeeto. And you are tuned in to episode 336 of the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. On this episode, man, I got the Inaudible Bros with me, man. We're going to discuss, we got a lot of things to talk about. We're going to talk about the Ime Udoka situation for the Boston Celtics. It's all over the place, man. We don't know what to believe, man. So we just still gathering all the facts, but we're going to try to make as much sense of it as we can. I am going to talk about the Brett Favre stuff. Y'all know I don't rock with dog, like, as it is. So I'm for sure going to talk about that. A little bit about fantasy football. E Ray's going to give us a little tease as far as for bench, flicks, and chill. Then we're going to talk some music. We got Smiles on for that. So y'all make sure y'all stick around. Also, man, make sure you catch my appearance. I did a guest spot over there on Life As I See It Pod with Jers, Gert, and then C. So shout out to everybody over there, man. I appreciate them for having me on. So when that drops, I'll make sure to share the link. But yeah, make sure you subscribe everywhere where podcasts are. Inaudible Ruckus on all platforms. Make sure you go to the website, inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Cop you some merch. Also check out midnightclubmerch.com for the Midnight Club merch. Also, Neezy, shout out to Neezy. She announced it on the Skeeters episode, man, but she got another sponsorship, man, so shout out to her. But make sure you cop the Naturally Named Moisturizer Dual as well, all right? About to get off into the show, man. Keep this shit booming. It's an Audible Ruckus, motherfucker.
All right, y'all. You already know what time it is. Get ready for the most electrified man in podcast. So put your headphones on and sit back as we get ready to bring the ruckus, motherfucker.
Give me the mic so I can take it away.
Now the party didn't start till I walked in, and I probably won't leave until the thing ends.
I'm like, what up, though? It's your boy Lo Gross. So Big Papa Skeeto, and this is episode 336 of the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. I'm here with the Inaudible Bros. Got my guy E-Ray. E-Ray, what's the word?
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? E-Ray, the quasi-bad guy, the Diet Coke of evil, the man of 7/8 teeth, back in the building once again. It's an honor.
This nigga.
Keep it short. Keep it short. I'm not about to do 82,000 AKAs like y'all been doing time. Lastly. I started some shit and now y'all just took it over. I'm all right, listen. I ain't got 8 minutes to listen to. Okay, AKA.
Hold on a second. Nah, you've been podcasting just like you in the podcast space. Your AKAs is like your rite of passage. Just like banging your set damn near. Nigga, you go to a nigga's show, you.
You've been gone for like 10 years, so you gotta come in with that.
Right.
Y'all know who the fuck I am.
Yeah. Exactly. You already know me. I ain't gotta say my name.
You already know what it is.
You get three. That's my new thing. If y'all wanna go long, go long. Y'all only getting three out of me. Done.
All right. Smiles.
I'll try that shit. Should I do?
No, because I wanted to say something else to you saying I only get three. Like, what do you? But you know,
nah,
I was like,
say it, Smile. Going. Say it. Say that shit, bro.
Three pumps? What,
three pumps? Yeah, the third. If you go more than three, you get a fine. Aquarius, Jamarius from Jackson State.
The Ricochet. That's a real one. What up, Smile? Right.
All right, it's your boy Smiles, aka You're On to Me, Greyjoy, aka Hip Hop Adam Schefter, aka T-Shirt Tom Brady, aka Hoodie Honcho, aka Maybach Smiles, aka Lake Show Smiles,
aka Muted Smiles. Don't give a fuck about your aka. Didn't you hear
that?
You can unmute it now. You still got something to fuck up. But you still...
I didn't even notice it until I was like, oh.
Right. 15 minutes later, he's still going. And it was like, oh, topics have started now.
Hey, for the listeners out there, man, to the inaudibles, man, y'all know what type of show this is about to be, man. Like, we ain't got no sense. So, Smilez, a.k.a. shut the fuck up.
A.k.a. quiet your ass down.
It was like, Smilez, a.k.a.
Like, shut up, nigga.
A.k.a. the pace, shut the fuck up. Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
I'm sorry, Smilez. Right. It's not your birthday anymore. You don't get no special privileges. They've all been revoked.
Right. Lowe was like, he like, I gave you a pass last week.
Oh yeah, because it was your birthday. I know your mom be listening, my mom be listening and stuff. They're probably listening this week, but hey man, we back to regularly scheduled programming.
And Smilez is the nicest human being on earth, ladies and gentlemen. And we just be fucking. That's what it tells you. Nice guys, they might not finish last, but they get abused.
Yeah, oh yeah, so for sure. For sure there's emotional abuse there.
Sorry. Oh yeah, because I don't even know if I really told you, E Ray, because I forgot to mention, you know, it was a good party, but one of the homies spoke to me about, like, yo, the fact that you had two chicks that you talked to in the same room and then had no issues, because
shit.
I know one,
the sister-in-law of the ex-co-host, remember the three you had the Naruto.
Hold on, Smilez. Before you continue on, tell the listeners what you're talking about.
You had a party for your birthday. You know,
young uncircumcised.
Whoa.
Insider for the
but outside. The
games were, right. Yeah. For the games they were going on, but
that PTO I know sex.
You got to fill the listeners in.
AKA young.
Yeah, so this past weekend, you know, we kind of teased it before, but, you know, had a nice little game night event at the crib, and about, you know, 10 to 12 folks came through, showed your boy love. Pretty much everybody bought their own bottles, but, you know, I also had like 15 bottles also.
And drugs.
On dick.
And drugs.
Mad liquor.
What? I do not know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I don't know about that part. I can't co-sign that, but there was a lot of legal beverages available.
Gotcha.
How's that? I know I did not consume in any of these illegal things because the liquor was good enough for me. But yeah, you know, it was a good night. You know, nice and enjoyable. We played Uno. I learned how to play gin. What did we play? We played the Game of Things. You know, that's a BGSU classic. You know, I had to bring up for the folks. You know, we also played this game called Urban Trivia that one of the homies, he created the game. So played that game. So it was definitely a fun, good night. Because, nice. Hey, at our big age, I'm good with a game night, some drinks.
That's how it's supposed to be. That raging out, doing the club hopping and shit, man, your liver is not going to be the same.
At all. And might I add, I just have to add this caveat. This nigga Smilez, since we're here, invite us to the spot, the new spot. We like, okay, let's see what Smilez doing right now. Next thing you know, I'm like, nigga, what is this? Is this Thriller? Like, the gate open, we get the address, and oh, I'm shit. Like, he's like, there's no building number, so I'm just like, but
y'all
I've been
in the projects. You know,
in my travels, I understand how to read the language. I'm like, okay, third. I was like, that means building that number? I was like, oh, okay. But I'm like, it's number one. Smilez building is like building 40. I'm like, there's no way it's 40 buildings in this complex. Uh-huh. So I'm driving. We driving around. I'm like, okay, 2, 12, 13.
32.
And then I see it. I'm like, 25. I'm like, oh, shit, maybe it is like 40-something. Yep. I was like, okay, well, let's keep driving. We drive around, swerve around, catch it. All right, cool. Get out. All the places lit up nicely. Cool. And then I'm looking, of course, the only building that Smilez is building, where we gotta go,
is the
dark
one.
As fuck.
Dark?
Like, dark. And I'm talking about like
dark, pitch
black, talking about Wesley Snipes black, talking about Bernie Mac's gums black. Damn. Like, shit was nuts. And I'm like, luckily I keep my blade on me.
Right.
Desert blade. Pulled that bitch out. I was like, just in case. I don't know if a nigga just hiding there. I was like, call Smilez real quick. Need to just make sure that right. Need to make sure that
just in case I got a gutter, nigga.
Like Bishop or somebody don't just come out the fucking shadows. what's up, Raheem?
Yeah. Jab, jab.
Right. Stick and move, stick and move. But I was like, okay. And then, mind you, again, we don't leave Smiles' home until 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning.
Y'all tripping.
It's still just as dark. And I'm like, and we come out as a group. Now it's about 5-6 of us. And everybody, like, the chick's like, I don't know. I'm like, look, hold on, I got it. Pull that shit out. Like,
Desert Blade.
Like, just in case. She's like, oh my gosh, it's somebody. I'm like, I ain't worried about no niggas. My hands work. I'm worried about these fucking cockroaches or something just drop down on me. Yeah, that's when I got an issue. You got, like, three random thugs, like Jimmy, Jake, and Paul. I'll beat they shit up like Maximum Carnage. But
yeah. Jimmy, Chicken,
fucking
Paul.
Damn cockroach land on my head. I'm like, ah!
Hey, facts. Big
facts. Like Prince, nigga. Facts. It's over.
Yeah. Oh, no. Get it off. Get it off. Oh, it's on me. Did it get me?
Oh, no. Shit. I promise you, the cockroaches out here in Texas,
oh, yeah.
One of them bitches land on me.
They buff as hell.
Y'all gonna be like, nigga, what the? I'm stripping butt ass.
Oh, no. How about, side note, how about, you know, when the weather changes, so sometimes, because down here in Texas, for the listeners out there, it ain't even about dirty or not dirty. It's just the climate. So you could go to the bathroom at 3 o'clock in the morning and there's a roach just crawling, or like one roach just crawling around or whatever, right? If you turn the AC off, like, oh, it's too hot. Or it's too cold. I'm just going to turn it off. If you do that at the heat of the summertime, or like, especially after it rains, they going to be in your shit. So Neezy was like, oh my God, it's a roach, kill it. And I went to go get it. And this motherfucker started flying at me. I had him, but when he flew at me, I was like, oh shit, this motherfucker flying. And I'm like, I had to do the Matrix.
That's when we lose it. Because again,
I ain't have it. I still got them.
Below the equator.
Yeah.
Because where y'all at? Y'all right? Y'all too close to the tropics.
Yeah.
So again, y'all got the shit to be like, they start doing some mutating and shit.
Yep.
The cockroaches out here, and ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, inaudibles, we say cockroaches for a reason, because those cockroaches, they call them aka palmetto bugs.
Mm-hmm.
They're fucking like the size of your palm.
Yeah.
And they just walking around
big,
like
Debo ass roach.
Yeah. Like, you got next? No, nigga.
And they rude as fuck. They don't give a fuck about nothing.
No.
I almost fucked up Neezy's workstation because one crawled in and I just pulled the spray out and just sprayed everything, all the electronics and shit. And then, like, then her shit, like, her computer wouldn't cut on Monday morning for work.
Right. She, like, why are
the surge protector was wet? I'm just shooting, bro. I ain't care.
We must protect this house.
Yeah, I just got it. I ain't care who was outside, bro. I just got the spray. And then like the surge protector was wet, the keyboard was wet, the monitor, like, our whole workstation just was lit up with bug spray. I ain't give a fuck. I got him.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
I ain't gonna lie. I would have been the same way. Like, I'll worry about this afterwards. Oh,
yeah. You gotta get your man.
Like, right. You come in this house.
Gotta die. I'm sorry. It's what it is.
I had a similar story to that years ago with my dad. We went to go pick up my cousin from Kentucky.
Oh, shit.
And so on the way down there, you know, my dad was like, all right.
The blue meth state.
Yeah. I'm gonna go pay for the gas and you pump the gas. I'm like, cool, bet. You know, I'm probably like high school or whatever around there. So I'm pumping the gas. And all I know, I just happen to look over and seen some big ass flying bug come towards me.
Yeah.
I dropped that gas thing so quickly and got back in the car.
Yeah.
My dad came out like, well, what happened? Why is it getting? I'm like, I don't know. I just saw this big ass bug. I said, fuck it.
Yeah. I don't do that. I don't do the bugs, Pops. And your pop probably look at you like, yo, sissy.
Right, he
why
was like,
"Why'd you ask for my Glock?"
Yeah, what? I'll shoot it. And look, knowing your pops, he probably could shoot that shit out of midair, nigga. And it'd be precision as fuck. You shoot the wings off a fly.
I was just about to say, curve the bullet around the corner. Yeah. Smiles like,
Smiles be like, "My daddy had caught a bullet with his bare hands, nigga."
Yep, I was like, I left that gas pump and everything all on the ground. I was like, "Fuck that, I'm getting the car."
Ain't no shame. Like that. Look. We could talk Buck stories all day long because, again,
E-Ray lived that shit.
I promise you.
The price of look, the price of paradise is not cheap.
Brand new car. I was trying to pump some gas for my because I like to play the Russian roulette game with the gas. Mm-hmm. Like, ooh, shit, my shit on E, but it tell me exactly how long I got. I was like, oh, yeah, I still got 20 miles. All right, cool. I still got 5 miles, and I like to get my gas, particularly from Sam's Club, save the most
okay.
I can. But this particular time, I just completely forgot, wasn't paying attention. And then I'm like, I don't know if I'll make the Sam's Club. QT is right here. Bet. I just washed my car, it's all good, and I left the car on while I was cleaning it. So the gas just steady getting grounded down. So I look, and my shit says 0.01. I was like, oh, shit, I got to stop for gas immediately. I make it to QT. I'm like, bet. The way my car's a brand new car, it locks if you get out of it and if you get into it. So I got the new cherry smell and all that shit. I pull up and I'm trying to pump the gas. All of a sudden, I'm like, oh, where's my wallet? I was like, damn, I left my wallet in here. I go look in the car. It's a bee sitting there like, what's up, nigga? Yeah. I was like, oh,
where
oh,
you shit. From?
I was like, all right, hold on. I was like, calm down. Open the door. It'll fly out. I open the fucking car door. His homie jump in too. Like, nigga, we
Oh shit, it's the hive.
Oh shit.
We at the hive.
Cause you know when you in the summer, especially like in these areas with the garbage can right there.
Yep.
They all flying around. So they having a fucking party.
Yep.
And now my car is freshly clean. It smells like cherries and shit. They're like, oh, what we can pollinate.
It's
this
sweet bitch. Over there too.
It's sweet
over there. I thought you was sweet. Like,
they thought shit was sweet.
A sweet and I
was
like, lick.
It's just all right. It's just a scent, niggas. So I'm trying to roll the windows down. I can't even get in my car because every time now the mug's following me. It was like the most horrendous thing ever. I was like, dude, how do I get myself in this situation? I know random white people right next to me are looking, not having no problems at all. Them bees was racist. As a matter of fact, the bees was racist.
Damn,
the bees and,
racist bees.
Because that white man had white privilege. That bee just sitting there like. I don't like his car and went straight beeline for me. Emphasis on the B.
I was like,
this is
some
bullshit. And again, for whatever reason, I somehow made it out of there. I was like, man, I'm struggling. I went, finally got the bees out of my car, drove to another pump and faced my car a different way, opposite of the actual garbage can. So I could be like, all right, cool. I get out and I'm like, I'm kind of nervous, right? I'm shaking, trying to get that card in there.
Yeah.
Pump 271. I'm like, all right, shit. Then a bee, I look down, bees fucking follow my legs. I'm like, this nigga's on me.
Yeah.
I was like, you racist. You racist bees. I'm only trying to put $10 in the tank so I can actually go to Sam's Club, my destination, to get the maximum savings.
Yeah.
I'm running from this bee and bobbing and weaving, pulling the Ali so much. I done fooled up the goddamn tank.
It is
I'm
like,
I'm like, fuck I'm it, like, I'm going home.
It don't matter. I'm
$45.
Right. Hey, bro.
I'm running around.
That's how that shit be. That's how that shit be.
I pull that shit out then, just gas it. I'm like, whew, finally. And I went on my way, but I was like, only I get into bullshit like this.
Hey, like, that's me. How it be, literally. Remember that?
Oh, man.
Hey, it be, hey, man.
Another day in the hoop.
No. Nah, so again, and I feel like we revving up again because you know summertime, like it be up and down, right? And I said this, so I did a guest spot on the Life as I See It podcast with the homie Jersey. Went over there. Shout out to Gert and C, because like we was in there chopping it up, man. Like you know, I got my shit off. Of course, I promoted us, promoted the shows, promoted the network. You know how we get down when we travel and whatnot. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. White games.
But on there, like we touched on a lot of things. But I was just talking about like the art of podcasting, and like you know, some weeks, You know what I'm saying? It's dry. It ain't shit going on. Then some weeks it's podcaster's paradise where it just be a bunch of shit, right? So we gearing back up to where, like, now we getting into, like, the nitty-gritty and shit, right? So I want to start. Well, I want to start with music first. Just kind of get this shit out the way. And then we can segue into, because I got some shit, man. I got some shit. I couldn't wait to pod all this right. week, man.
All right.
Shout out to my Atlanta folk, man. Goddamn, man. Oh, man, you know what I'm talking about, man? Goddamn.
This one of them paradise weeks.
Man, damn near. So, Smiles, real quick. I want to start off with you. There's, you know, and I'm, so two things on this show. I've been critical of J. Cole, which I've already done relinquished that and moved on from that. So I don't know why people.
Good on you.
Right.
Good on you.
Because, again, it was a running gag, but then at some point you got to retire it and move on. But for some reason, people won't let me make it. Like, they still, I'm like, I'm not hating on J. Cole no more, man. Like, it's over. So y'all know my criticism of J. Cole in the past, and then my criticisms of Jeezy. And just kind of his fall off the cliff, if you will, right? So recently, Jeezy had a feature on ESTG on his album. Now, ESTG is from Kentucky. He signed to Yo Gotti's label. One of the hottest people in the game right now. Everybody on Gotti's label is hot. Everybody that signed to CMG is hot as a stove in 94, as they would say, right?
Yep.
The last track, well, I didn't hear the album yet because I like ESTG, so I'm a ride to that shit, some hood shit. But the last track is a song featuring Jeezy called The Realist, and ESTG went, he got off on his shit. Then Jeezy came in sounding like the old Jeezy, like trap Thug Motivation 1-on-1 Trap or Die Jeezy. The Jeezy that we have been asking for all this time, and he did not disappoint. And I'm saying that to y'all because I'm always critical of him. I gotta give credit where credit is due. Man, like, he came back with one of those vintage verses. Now, I'm like, okay, well, do he got, like, 12 or 14 more of those? So I just want to ask y'all, have y'all heard this track or, like, heard this verse? And if so, what are your thoughts?
I actually heard it because I saw you post about it because I hadn't got a chance to check out the ESTG album yet. Mm-hmm. I'm like, oh, I'll get to it when I get some time to really run it by. But when I saw you post, I'm like, oh. If Lo posted about
the I'm back the posting Jeezy again verse. Too, by the way. I'm back posting again. I was kind of like double dutch like, social media.
Yeah, I know that you've been on it, like dropping jewels, and it was like
I'm back.
Yeah.
Jewels and choruses and all that shit. Yeah,
you know.
9 to 5, 5 to 9. Nine. I got a 9 to 12. All right, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. But yeah, so I had to go check out the song and I was like, okay. And then yeah, when Jeezy came, I was like, oh. Shit, let me run this back.
That's right. Damn.
And it even made me want to go check out that he got a new joint with DJ Drama that's also out that came out a couple weeks ago. So I'm like, okay. I heard that. I'm like, oh, that one was cool. I'm like, oh, if Jeezy can keep this going, he might be back. I don't know about him dropping like an album, maybe like a little EP or something. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know. Well, hold on. Before you go, E-Ray, because E-Ray about to jump in. Freddie Gibbs drops next week, and we'll cover that when it drops. But I've heard he dropped another single today called Dark Hearted. I don't think Jeezy ready, but that's a whole other story. I ain't even trying to pit them together like against each other, but it is what it is. But like,
if you ain't trying, don't even do.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah. What up, though? It's your boy Big Low Gross, and I'm letting y'all know, man. Y'all listening to the Inaudiverse, man. That's right. Sometime. A while back, man, we converted the show from just a podcast, man, to the Inaudiverse. So we got like 5 shows, you know what I'm saying? We got Music Impulse with Smiles. We got Let Me Book the Territory with E-Ray. We got Binge Flicks and Chill with E-Ray. We got the regular show, Inaudible Ruckus, that you're probably listening to now. And then we got the Skeeters podcast. And then we got some other shows that we're working on, man. So keep rocking with us, man, and welcome to your experience inside of the Inaudiverse. Motherfucker.
But I can't remember if I heard this song or if I heard the one that Smile was talking about with DJ Drama.
Okay.
Whichever one, somebody played as a sleeper on the JBP, and that's where I heard it. And I was like, oh, that sounds good. I don't give a shit about that. But I was listening to it, like, oh, that actually like goes. And I was like, oh, this is good music. So I think it was the one that you're talking about, because I was like, oh, that they both was going getting off on that song. But when Jeezy came on, that's when it really turned out. I was like, oh, this
And shout out to my dog Aunt Paige, man. He from the city, man. He another podcaster in the space. And he was like, he made a post and he was like, ESTG, everybody was saying, oh, he the new Jeezy. So Jeezy probably felt the way and was like, look here, nah. Or he was like, all right, if you're going to be the new Jeezy, let me bless you with a track. Either way, Jeezy was like, Jeezy said, hold my beer or hold my tequila. Like, I'm about to be outside. So hats off to Snow, man, because I'm always giving him a hard time. But I just want more from him because, like when I always here's my thing. Jeezy and his contemporaries is always Rick Ross, Gucci, and Yo Gotti. You could throw Boosie in there, maybe. Like those are his contemporaries, though. And when you look at it, all his other contemporaries either, like, stay consistent across the board or continue to elevate. Jeezy's just kind of just been, like, up and down. You know what I'm saying? But he never quite, like, rose back up.
Took off,
yeah. Yeah, no, he took off, but he didn't, like, go back up again.
Let's say, who are the three other contemporaries that you mentioned?
Rick Ross, Yo Gotti, and Gucci Mane.
And that's why. So right there, you just literally hit it. Those three, they've stayed at like a low cruising altitude. So it was high enough to be like noticed, but they never reached like just a level where superstar. They're inescapable.
Yeah.
Jeezy was inescapable from a time from that, like probably 05 to about 07?
09. I'll give him about 09.
Okay. Somewhere around the, I think he tapered off right after the inauguration, somewhere around that time frame of Obama.
Yep.
So,
my president is black, my Lambo's blue. Yes, and if you listen to the rest of that song, it don't be saying shit.
Yeah.
About politics and
nothing.
But that was the thing that I got from them. Like, those guys you can constantly listen to, and I'll stick to that forever. I always say that anytime you have a person that is like consistent, because that's how Rick Ross survived the 50 shit. Because 50 hit that stratosphere, and when you came back that high, there's only one place to go
down.
Versus everybody else is like, oh, we could just stay right here. This is like perfect. It's not too low, not too high.
Just ride this altitude out. That's what Gucci did.
No bird.
Gucci did that. Gucci found his pocket and just rode his pocket out. Even when he crashed out, he did crash out. Got locked up, went away, niggas wrote him off, came back. But because of what he put into the next generation, he was able to just kind of float back up to a little bit slightly higher than where he was at before then. And Yo Gotti even was like, all right, well, I'm going to take a step back. Because this is another reason why I compare all of those people, because they all launched labels and like all like have people that came up underneath them. And of all of them, Jeezy had the biggest head start, but the people that came under him weren't as prolific as the people that came under everybody else. Not the Meek Mills, you know what I'm saying, the Migos, Moneybag, yo. Anybody that's come up underneath all these other artists have not blown up the way like under Jeezy.
And I think that's the reason, because again, his star was way too bright where nobody else, we didn't care. If they wasn't literally Jeezy, we didn't care. Versus Rick Ross. Rick Ross wasn't like the hottest thing ever. So the other people got to come out and they get the affiliation of Rick Ross.
Yeah.
And then they could go where Rick Ross maybe couldn't at the time. Like, I remember when Wale first signed with Maybach. I was like, oh, is he going to switch to some like ridiculous hard shit? And then he came out with Ambition and it was like, oh, no, he tricked us, nigga. Yeah. He's doing the same.
He tried to trick us. Yeah.
Work. I was just fooling y'all. Throw this flower bomb. I was like, damn, that was smart. So again, that was one of those that I was like, that's dope. Also, again, like you said with Yo Gotti has never hit like mainstream. White people don't be like,
yeah. He had a couple bangers, but not enough to push him to the forefront.
Yep. Absolutely. Yeah. But that's again where you want to stay if you want all your other projects to be successful. Because again, as long as us, and it sounds crazy, but as long as like you stay within the confines of like the black stratosphere, then everything else you come out with can surpass you. And we might not even know you have any attachment to it for real. And then the white people might gravitate or grab onto the other mainstream, I should say.
Yeah.
Will gravitate or grab onto those things. But again, it's because those guys weren't like the brightest stars. So we gave everything a chance coming out their camp because we don't know it's their camp.
Facts. Mm-hmm. Facts. That's true.
Yeah. because I even go along with that, I want to touch on like the whole YG thing. Yeah, we knew YG was signed to him early on, like that first album, but after that, Jeezy didn't put his arm around YG.
Nah, he
it
didn't.
Was just like
he did.
It was just like YG just does his own thing. We know he signed the Def Jam.
Same thing with Freddie Gibbs. Freddie Gibbs, 2-11. It's a bunch of artists. Blood Roth, Slick Pullet, like Tone Trump. Jeezy had a whole lineup, a whole roster. 2-11, like he had a whole bunch of people, and he was doing like what Yo Gotti's doing. Basically, he's just signed a bunch of hood dudes.
Even your young boys from Detroit.
Yep, Dope Boy Cash Out. You know what I'm saying?
Hello, I'm gonna break this to you. In wrestling terms, he had a bunch of Steves. He had a label of Steves. Yeah. It's like, oh, okay, yeah, like who's that? They're really good at their thing, but they don't have nothing to pop off.
Wait, E-Ray, for the listeners on this show, explain what a Steve is.
So, ladies and gentlemen, in the wrestling terms, where you get like one of these really good technical wrestlers or somebody that has a lot of like it factor when it comes to the art of wrestling, but they have nothing as far as like star power or something that pops them off, I label them a Steve because it's literally... I see them in the ring. I don't remember their name. I was like, oh, that was cool what they did. And then they're gone out of my brain. Same thing for all the niggas that Lo just named. I have no idea who 98% of the people that were signed to Jeezy are. But I'm assuming they probably could rap pretty good. They got a good verse. But they didn't have enough to be like the world gravitate onto
to
like,
check for them.
Oh, that's that guy. Like,
but that's why I champion for Freddie Gibbs so much, because if Jeezy would have did for Freddie what Meek Mill did, or what Rick Ross did for Meek Mill, like where you just like, all right, look, I'm starting this, I'm gonna hand you the keys, run it. Jeezy never did that. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm always like pick at that shit. Because it's like, bro, like you didn't set yourself up for the long run, but who knows like what his goals and what his philosophies are, right? But it is a music business, right? And so another topic that came up was Future sold his publishing rights for, they said, anywhere. It was like 75 to 85 million. And everybody's like, that don't seem like it's enough. And I'm like, what? So that was what people were saying. So I'm bringing that up to y'all. But I thought about it like this. Remember he had a dispute with Rocco and stuff because he had signed with Rocco first, and then that's when he did the two albums. That's where I feel like Future took a turn, because he was going up a certain trajectory, and then he got into that trouble, like, because he owed Rocco and this and that. So he did two albums that he just tossed out, like, all right, let's just get these over with just so I can fulfill that, and then I'll be good. But he has some singles that Mask Off and a couple other songs from that double album that went. And it was like, all right, well, Future Hendrix is the nigga. Like, so just what's your thoughts on him selling the catalog? Do you think he got his worth? Like, it was stupid. Should he have held on to it? Smiles, I'm going to start with you.
Oh, well, as far as the catalog, I think he definitely didn't get his worth, because everybody know, either way, like him or not, this nigga is still like the hottest nigga when it comes to rap. Like,
he got a hive. He's the only nigga that got a hive.
Yeah, it's like Future Hive is real. So yeah, I don't think he got enough for it. But with all these people selling their publishing and all that, we don't know the details and the legalities of what it means, because it could be just for up to a certain amount of.
No one knows what it means.
But yeah, it could be just like up to like whatever albums he just dropped, and he might be like, oh no, I might exclude this single or whatever. So like whatever he comes out with next, he could be like, all right, yeah, that's cool, but whatever the next single or the next album might garner me, 100-150. So
yeah,
it's like, because we don't know the details, so it's like, all right, like, no, I trust him, so whatever, we'll see.
That's true. E-Ray,
I disagree with you, Smiles, a bit, mainly because. I don't see any of his songs reaching that mainstream stratosphere. Like, they're not playing March Madness at graduation. It's just not happening. So even though
I like March Madness, though,
I know we like March Madness, but them, where the people who are the commodifiers of music, the main people who create the streams and the sales, mainstream America, are not like super heavy on Future Hendrix or Future Hive.
It's BA, Black IRS, aka Black Wall Street, in the building.
Yo, it's J-Mo. Let me book the territory's residential white guy.
Yeah, our Caucasian correspondent. This is E Ray, the quasi bad guy, the Diet Coke of evil, Peen Malenko. You know, of course, the American cream, Brody Lodes.
And I am your pod guy, your pod tribal chief, the boy A-Dub in the building. And this is Let Me Book the Territory, the greatest four-man wrestling podcast known to mankind.
Absolutely. And you can catch us now on Inaudible Ruckus Presents. And we'll be here every Friday, ladies and gentlemen. So if you're ready for it, too sweet me when you see me and let the madness run wild. Yeah.
Yeah.
What launched him into that? Remember when he had Kelly Rowland? He had a song with, and it was somebody else. He had crossed over into that pop space, yeah. Rihanna and stuff. But then he, you got all the answers. I got all the questions.
But that's where he was going
and now
he's just making.
Then he said, "I heard all them babies," and people was like, yeah. "Fuck Future."
He started making nigga music, like only nigga music, like
double down. Yeah. I'm not mad at that.
But I love it though. He tried that shit. He came back to the hood where he's like, "They gonna love me regardless, so I'm gonna stay here." Mm-hmm.
Literally, because again, the term Hive. Outside of Beyonce, Beehive, Future started that.
Yeah.
This is like the stands.
Yes.
Mm. Came from Eminem writing a song about stand. Yeah. So it's like, oh, you're a stand for this particular thing. Beehive was a thing. It was like, oh, we're part of Beehive. And it was like, well, the niggas got Future. We Future Hive, Hendrix Hive. And it's like, that doesn't make sense. That's how great it is.
Right.
Shit is absolutely asinine.
Not a Drake Hive. A Future Hive.
Future.
Because we don't like Drake, but we like Future. Mm-hmm. Okay, got it.
And then that's when it became everybody start having hives, Lawrence mm-hmm. Hive, blah, blah, blah. So it's just like, it stands for like the toxic nigga, the antithesis of the female hive thing. It was like, oh, let's just stand for this nigga. Like,
yeah,
this nigga Hive, and we just want to be a part of it. So again, that was the thing. So I think he's doing a good job, but I also think he got what his catalog essentially was worth. In that regard, because yeah. I'm thinking the big play. For me personally, I think the big play of all of these sellings of catalogs and things are going for streaming, and like how the streams are going to be used
yep.
for the big streaming comes, I should say, mm. are going to be used in movies and stuff where they don't have to mm-hmm. ask the person anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So when, let's say Warner Brothers owns all this publishing, all this music, and then, I don't know, Paramount just like, oh, we just need this. They just go straight to Warner Brothers. It's mm-hmm. a bang, bang. And they yeah. can make all the small dollars that, so, let's say, Future isn't going to do himself.
Yeah.
So that's mm-hmm. where I think that's where the industry is going. So the big thing is to just get your payout.
Yeah.
Unless you're going to do the hustle for your dollars.
So let me ask you this, because I'm with you there. I'm following. Like, that's what I was thinking, too. But from a Future standpoint, that's what the industry is trying to do. From a Future standpoint, do you think it's like, look, man, I'm over this shit. Let me just get as much as I can get right now. And then I'm 75 million. Like, we looking at, oh, he yes. didn't get his value. But 75 million is enough to do whatever the fuck you want to do, especially on top of what you already have. So he can go have 15 million rallies and like wing stops across the country and eat forever. Like, literally.
I mean, but
the main question.
Yes. Yes, I get that, and I agree with that. Plus, you got to factor in the fact that he's not, like, done.
Yeah.
He's still making music, so he sold that part of his catalog. He can still, because he doubled down on his particular base,
yeah.
he can still create more music for them, and it's going to still garner him a certain
another
amount.
75 million.
So that's fine.
At least.
But, and I'll say, and again, like I was saying, it's not like a Whitney Houston or a Mariah Carey where it's pretty easy to be like, hey, I can license this song out to here, there. Everybody's not running up to the Future catalog to put that in a commercial.
Right.
That's what
it's
I
only
mean.
A handful like, of songs. Like you said, March Madness, Tony Montana, like the bigger records.
Exactly. And even yeah. then, I don't think they're going to get as much mainstream usage as somebody that's a lot more easily quantifiable in the mainstream media. So
yeah.
that's why, I mean, I think you got what his catalog is worth. And it's a great deal because he's still able to continue to make music and his base hasn't waned, at least not to my knowledge. I think people still really fuck with Future.
They do.
But go ahead, the question I wanted to ask y'all, not to be in, you know, another man's business, how much of that, say, $75 million is going to the baby mamas?
$75.
Right. Nigga, all of
my man, because my man said he broke. He like, I can't afford this. Right.
He's all in my company.
Right. Yeah, to answer your question, man, probably all of it, man. I ain't gonna hold you up. Real quick, before we cut to some music, did y'all peep the shit that happened between Tory Lanez and August Alsina? E-Ray, you the R&B dude, man. Make sense of this for us.
R&B 2.0.
The R&B niggas harder than the rap niggas, man.
Yeah.
So for the listeners out there, apparently there was a backstage show and August Alsina walked past Tory Lanez. Tory Lanez tried to dap him and August didn't like pay him no attention.
August did a speed walk like he was on the runway past him. Hansel.
Yeah. So apparently then they later on had a conversation about it and Tory Lanez decided to just punch him in the face.
Well, I mean, from what I've seen, it was it happened this way. I could be wrong, but I watched like little clips of what happened. They showed initial, like, I guess Tory Lanez was coming one way, him and his bodyguards, and August Alsina was coming the other way. Tory put his hand out, was like, "Yo, August." And he just super
swoop, speed walked right past that. Yep.
Yeah.
And like he's saying, it wasn't like a, "Oh, I didn't see." Because I do that. I'd be like, "Oh, I didn't even see," because I'm so focused. This nigga was just like, like he was just oomsing to his own beat.
Yeah.
And then Tori's like, he looking at his hand like, "Nigga, what was that about?" And then the comedian people, some of the like IG comedian people were backstage. Was standing there. So they were hyping it like, "What the fuck? Like, what was that?"
No, because Tory had his hands still up. So somebody walked up and was like, "You know how you see a nigga get left hanging?" You're like, "Oh, I got you, bro. It's all good."
And he's just like, "What the hell?" So he's like, "All right, hold up." And they're like, "You don't even need to do that. You don't need to." He's like, "Nah, let me go talk to this nigga." And that's when he went to talk to him. They had a disagreement, apparently. And then you got to Tuesday. Then Tory was like, "I just left that."
Well, no. August said that he released a statement saying that he couldn't. His doctor and everybody advised him that because of monkeypox and coronavirus to not dap nobody up.
Yeah,
that was his rationale.
Yeah, I was like, "My nigga, you in a crowded ass club and you ain't supposed to be touching no hands."
Right, and he ain't had no mask on. He was sitting there. Right. He walked past, deliberately walked straight past the bodyguards, beeline through them. You could have said, "What's up?" You can acknowledge him. It's very easy. Like, I don't touch everybody's hand. I'll be like, "Yo, what up? What's going on, bro?"
Yep.
And keep it moving. It's the acknowledgement. The fact that he literally, Tory had his hands out, had the shoulder turned, ready to receive the dap. And this nigga act like he was a fucking defensive end. Huh!
Yeah, up and under.
Right. Move. Bull rush.
Gotta go underneath.
Right, and just hit the fucking bag and went straight past him. I was like, "What was that? That was weird." And then didn't even break stride. Like, "Oh, my bad." Like, because he heard the commotion that it caused.
Yeah,
it was on some bullshit.
Yeah,
and whether he deserved to get boo-bopped for it, I mean, you be the judge of that. Me personally, because Tory already is in legal troubles, I would have probably.
Well, that's the thing. So it's being brought up, like, the aggressiveness of that happened, and while he's under, like, you know, so he's still awaiting like all the proceedings for the stuff with the Meg situation. So,
but clearly Tory doesn't care because he has an album that's supposed to be dropping called "Sorry for What" on the date that they were supposed to originally have the court date that has now since been postponed.
Oh, I'm checking that out because I still like Tory music.
The baby, he just dropped a project today.
No one's gonna
really check it out, probably except for me. But on one of the songs, my man the baby said, "Hey, I was out here smashing on Meg Thee Stallion. In fact, I smashed her the day before the Tory Lanez shit."
So, the real question is, does Meg have a short nigga fetish? Like, does she like munchkins?
Probably.
come here. I can like She-Hulk.
Smiles.
Come here, nigga.
That's what's going on. Smiles. Is she still with Party?
Yep.
Yes.
Party a real like nigga this, to be putting like up with all this
like
shit.
A week ago, like she had like her ass like in his lap while he was playing Call of Duty or some shit. Hey.
Sounds like a good time.
Hey, yeah, it looked fun. Yeah. It looked fun.
Yeah, that's what I was like. I was like, my man had the controller right on the ass. I was like, oh yeah, that looks like it.
The best of both worlds.
But I mean, honestly, he did say something about Party in the record too. Like he. Baby be shooting. So
baby,
like,
baby is baby 50 though. Like 50 be in his ear. Like, hey man, keep going.
And
keep,
that's how I found about the song. Niggas. I saw a 50 Cent post about it. That's how I found about the song. I was like, what?
Baby done shot like 40 niggas, beat up like 20 niggas, and he still
that's what he said.
And killed three niggas and still like.
And still
he said,
on top.
Hey, maybe that's why she was mad at him for doing the song with Tori.
Maybe. Mm-hmm. Oh no. All right. Let's cut
it's
to some
all
music.
Messy.
It is. Mm-hmm. It's all bad. It's all bad. Let's cut to some music. Then we're going to come back. This first track is called American Idols by the homie Alex Kane, featuring somebody that y'all may know or not. I don't know. And then the next track after that is 1090 by the homie RudeBoy Deago,
young
man.
Pinky Rings.
Pinky Rings. It's an audible ruckus. Motherfucker.
Welcome back.
Boop, bow you.
Yeah. Okay. They cut your hand off for reading, but they gave you a bite. Sing and you dance to be America's idol. Built it on our backs, but never gave us a title. Dropping choppers in the hood, selling crack for survival. Try to do it for ourselves, they gon' come through and burn. Call us savages and crooks, so what the fuck did we learn? No matter the president, it ain't no different than Kermit. Your representation matters, but my niggas is hurting. With my hand on the Bible, and I solemnly swear to lead them all with more shoes than one nigga can wear. You can say it was a choice and all, but I wasn't there. Look, I'ma stay fresh and ball, cause it never was fair. Yeah, we came a long way, but we too close to forget it. System kill us in the streets, and our government let it. Nah, they ain't trying to listen unless you fuck with their pockets. Lock us up to make a profit, they too greedy to stop it. Fuck.
The truth just stepped in the door, the spook that sat by the door. You never met me before, the magazine stretched down to the floor. By a backlink, I'm spazzing with glasses. The revolution was never broadcasted, it was podcasted. I spoke prophecies to y'all asses, fake niggas perpetrated, and y'all gassed it. I carry the torch with a passion, can y'all match it? Kill them slow and bury them all in a tall casket. It goes down in the jungle where gorillas live. Yeah, 12 killing kids baptizing alcohol down a razor blade. Cause bloodshed is imminent. The black American dream is a bigger career. And an escalade in the front yard. Singing Amazing Grace while we stuntin' hard. Pinky ring full of black diamonds. Living above the law. Sundays reading songs, stuffing weed inside the king palm. Nigga, I ain't stuntin', y'all.
Definitely an all for me, dog.
What up, though? It's Uncle Skeetar, and you are listening to the Inaudible Ruckus podcast. Okay, make sure you subscribe on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, and on SoundCloud. Okay, you can also go to the website and cop you some merch, inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Solid dudes, solid topics, solid music. Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker. Look at
me. Dark side west street, I'm in the field with it. Came around with it, all and got killed with it.
He gave that boy a gun, went to court and got killed with it. Home team shooters and they coming off the bench with it. Take a good look in my eyes, ain't no bitch in it. Take a good look at this Glock, got a switch in it. Been a real nigga from no jump, ain't no switching it. Ain't fucked girly in some years, but she missing it. Summer fiends, soft white balls, they say I'm pitching it. Ask me where my favorite room at, I said the kitchen is. Send my charm noodle, but it's VS in my shit. A day later, now I'm drinking margaritas with this bitch. 350 cost me six, I wore Adidas on this bitch.
What's she all on your dick?
I'm Justin Bieber to this bitch. Chewing on this good wood, she like a beaver on the dick.
Ooh,
I'm conceited with my shit. He looking mad at his bitch,
he must concede that I'm a hit.
I'm looking mad at your clicker, I can see that they gon' snitch. Put him in that room, they gon' fold under pressure. About to hit the road with a low, give him testers. Just give her good dick, she don't care if I stress her. Tell her less, it's sex, she don't know I'm about to bless her. She
picking them McQueens, give her that and Jimmy Choo. Might do the DNG, give me that and Christian Lou's. Spend the money on the gram, you at home miserable. The man right here, you don't need Mr. Cole. The main reason why I upload the video. I've been in my inbox begging you a silly hoe. Pulling all these niggas cards on Pokemon and Yu-Gi-Oh. Old word, he got session, pop him in the studio. Now I'm stabbing up decks around with a bougie-o. Nappy ass dread, spread it like Coolio. Perks and Patron, now we mixing Julio. Put it right out her mouth, put it in her booty hole.
Shout out to Jehovah.
It's hot. Daddy is hot. All right, that first track was American Idol by the homie Alex Kane, and then 1090 by RudeBoy Deago. I'm back with the gang, man. Smiles, what up, though?
What's good?
Sorry for muting your mic in the first segment, Smiles. I know our moms are listening, and I that is not reflective of the man that I am. I'm sorry.
Man that I am.
No, it's absolutely reflective of the man.
For sure.
That he
My
is.
Fingers was crossed
the man
when I said
wants
it.
To be.
Yeah. The person I want
to
be and who I am.
Better.
Yes.
Who I am today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Shut up.
I ain't shit today. E-Ray knows me. A little too well, might I add. I have to switch it up.
Hey, we like Two-Face.
I'm gonna have to do the E-Ray and just start being contrarian.
I'm the
shiny
side
not
of
me.
The coin. You the one that got blown up, the evil side, the dark side of the coin.
For real. Like he's the attorney general and shit that's like, oh, I'm here to save the country. Right. I'm the one that's like, right. Hey.
We need a beacon. And he's like.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm the one that's like, man, it would be cool to, like, you know what I'm saying, tie you up upside down over a bat of acid and just, like, think that somebody will save you.
Yeah, Lowe's foreplay games are wild. This guy,
right? I was like, yeah.
Him and the wife got to keep it spicy.
Hey, man.
Like, right. What's that? Don't mind this bat of acid. No, don't even. It's all good.
Just
baby.
Burn a little bit. Rather that burn than something else. No.
You got a bang, 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 bang.
Put it in. Let me put it in.
Oh, man.
All right, anyway. Speaking of putting it in, all right. Ime Udoka, no play.
Listen to the Skeeters every Thursday.
Thanks, Mom. All
right, somebody was skeeting. Skeet.
Do y'all want to go there first?
We there. Ties into a lot of
stuff. Let's get it out the way. Because we probably could have led off with it, but I like to bury it a little bit. You know what I'm saying? You got to stick around. You got to stick
Apparently
around.
Apparently so does he. I mean.
So, okay. Ime Udoka, head coach for the Boston Celtics. Do it like this. Oh yeah, do it like that, daddy.
Right. Over there.
I don't know how we gonna get this.
The ball.
Ball placement. If I put my hand here,
pull up,
get to me up high. No, I'm dropping out here, dropping low.
It might have been even worse if he was here in Dallas. A lot of butts around the Dallas.
Yeah, because Boston ain't got anyway. He was suspended for a year for violating team policies. Now. I know there's been a lot of talk on Twitter and the media cycle. I watched ESPN today to see how they covered it. I watched the press conference from the Boston Celtics, right? Because, you know, podcastrial integrity. We real diligence. Journalists on here. We do our due diligence and whatnot. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, as I'm presenting it to you guys, the listeners, some things don't add up, right? So, we'll speculate, but I'm just going to present it to you as it was presented to us. He was suspended for having what they are labeling a consensual relationship with a female employee for the Boston Celtics.
Yeah, a staffer.
So
that's important. Yes. That language is important because that staffer means that's somebody under his head coaching regime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So that, because I mean, honestly, let's keep it real here. In the NBA, NFL, at Smiles' job, everybody's job.
Yep.
People be mingling.
Yeah.
And it doesn't necessarily matter as much unless there is like a unfair leverage.
Or like a direct report. If it's somebody that reports to you and you have a position of power over them.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, and I say that to say, so of course, Twitter going Twitter. They start digging around. They go to the Boston Celtics website. Go to the like, staff bio.
Who could this be?
Look for any woman. They throw a woman up there. This is the only woman on the staff, so it has to be her. And it's like, they like, it's not her. Mm-hmm. But, well.
It is her.
Well.
And some
Boston is being real like tight about it. And so here's the thing, right? So before we get into it, I'm just trying to paint everything before we dive into it, right? So that's the one thing. But then there's another conflicting report saying that Ime Udoka made unwarranted comments, like inappropriate comments to the woman staffer, and that he was just doing some type of egregious behavior and stuff. So there's mm-hmm. conflicting reports out there. And I saw, this is what shifted me to the latter, is because Matt Barnes said something defending him, but then took that down and then came back and make a recanted. Statement. Yes, he recanted his statement. And I trust what Matt Barnes say. I want to hear what Jalen Rose has to say. The people that are inside the game and like know mm-hmm. and like tapped in to find out what's what, and people will confide in him. He's like, it's messy. He's like, it's messy and it's a lot. So my thing is, right, before I throw it to y'all, is this shit consensual or not? Before I determine, like, oh, they did dog dirty. Why they had to suspend them like this and that? So, what do y'all make of it? E-Ray, I'm gonna start with you. Like, what do you make of all of this? Like, what's right? What's wrong? Like, what do you need to see before you believe it or don't believe it? Like, what's up?
So it's a lot going on with this particular situation. The latest reveal is what I guess the gentleman who. Because all these people that he had, and now it's not just one affair. It seems like there's multiple women or some wild. So this is the latest that okay. has been, okay. and again, this we don't know if it's true or not. This is speculation. It's speculated that he had sex with the VP of finance's wife. Then sent some type of like, send some messages. Whatever to some people. I don't know what that means. The VP of finance wanted this to be public, this information, probably because it would help him in a divorce.
Right.
Let's be real. He impregnated somebody, Ime.
What?
He did. Yeah, he didn't out me. He left it Ime.
he left it in me.
And
pause.
Like he.
Grown men don't say pause, bro.
Yeah, and it's not just one woman. It seems like it was multiple married women that he was sleeping with. And.
They asked him to stop and he did it.
Yeah.
Stop it. You must stop it now. No.
So the thing is,
I gotta keep going.
I want to take it. I'll let y'all finish this before I take it off of this.
Well, hold on. Real quick, before you take us away. Also, for those who don't know, Ime Udoka is longtime fiance of Nia Long. Which is why it's getting so much attention in the Black Twitter sphere, because it's like, nigga, you cheated on Nia Long, but continue. Go ahead. Right.
Yes. So that was another thing that Nia Long had just moved, or they had been searching for a house. She moved her son or their son, I don't know if whatever the case may be, out there, and they were going to move to Boston. And he knew the whole time as he was having these affairs, he already knew this. And still had them out there looking for houses. That's been another random report. And was like, okay, I gotta tell her now. She just found it out with like everybody else, even though this information had been floating around the organization as it typically is months prior.
Yep.
So before they launched the investigation itself. So there's a few things to break down. One being that it does matter if it was a consensual relationship, but not in the fact of the organizational rules. The organizational rules meaning you have to declare any type of relationship, mm-hmm, number one, mm-hmm. and they may have like penalty against it because it could lead them open to, as Smiles said, like some type of legality.
Yeah.
Because like what's being reported, first it was said to be consensual, and now they're saying that the one of the women or the woman, I don't even know at this point, is saying that maybe she's kind of going back on what she said and that it was something else. So even then, this is why they're like, basically the Celtics like, look, this is why we told you don't be doing that shit in the first place.
Right.
Because even if they say something now, they could always change course, and whether she's telling the truth or not. That's not up to question.
You putting us out there to where we have to deal with this in the first place.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. It's like, don't embarrass us as an organization. And I think that's more important than saying if the woman is telling the truth or not, or the women, that doesn't matter.
Well, this is what I got.
At least not to me.
Facts. For me, I just was like, this is indicative of he's not really their guy. Because this happens all the time in organizations. Like you said, it happens at work. It happens everywhere. I can think of Eric Spoelstra, who married or like is his longtime girlfriend. At least I don't know if he's like married to her, but like he dated or is dating or is married to a ex-Heat dancer. Mm-hmm. While he was the video, like, and you know he had to meet her, like, I was going to drop some videotape off to the players, and he catch the girls dancing at practice or whatever. Hey,
oh, okay. Try to go out the drink. I got the video.
I'm making that shit up. But you know what I'm saying. It's proximity, and it's just you in there, whatever, right? But...
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
If he was the guy, this would have never came out, one. But this shows you that they didn't give a fuck about him because, like, yes, they not giving us no information, but the fact that they even made everything that's happening private is, like...
Public.
Yeah. They're making it public. It's like, bro, come on.
Every step of the way. They're not even allowing us to be like, let's just wait. Like, people are saying, well, let's just wait till all the facts come out because, again... Mm-hmm. Things keep changing.
They getting in front of it. They trying to. It's like they trying to get in front of it. Like, we ain't with that shit. Mm-hmm. Whatever he's on, we told him to stop it. He didn't do it. Our hands are done.
But devil's advocate, they could have known that this was coming, and that's why they're like, let's get ahead of it now.
Yeah.
And kind of distance ourselves from him because we like, oh, this shit has gotten mad messy, and we are already like, I don't know. But as they start doing their internal investigation, they're like, oh, this shit goes
but goes deep. To Stephen A's point, though, Stephen A, he had some good points on TV today. Uh-oh. No, he said, like, but why are you suspending him then? Just go ahead and fire him. His career is already ruined at this point, right? At least for the time being. He could be redeemed later on. We don't know. Again, we got to see how it shakes. But, like, why we're going to suspend him for a year? Just fire the nigga then. And then, like he said, you could have just fired him. And if they asked, well, why did y'all fire him out of nowhere? He took y'all to the finals. Ask him. And then leave it at that. Mm-hmm. That was the realest take that nigga's had in a long time. Like, I'm like, oh, that actually makes sense.
Especially because whoever, what the assistant coach or whoever about to replace him, if that nigga takes him to the finals again, nigga be like, why bring you back if this guy did just as good of a job as you did without you? Yeah. Or even a better job.
Yep. This is like Mark Jackson.
Yep. Right.
Hey, but Mark Jackson ain't going to racist ass Boston. Let's also talk about
the scandal.
Yeah. Let's talk about how racist Boston is, though. Like,
but I mean,
your pocket fucking car, you fucking nigga.
Stephen A was wilding, though. He made that point, but was that before or after he said Malika Andrews, you ain't gonna shut me down, you gonna stop me?
That was before. No. Hey, he was right though, because she misinterpreted what he had said. It's like she said something else, and he was like, "That's not what I said, though." So I can understand where he was coming from when he did that to her, but it's his show. He right. Like, hey, don't check me. Check your back tooth.
Don't check me, check your sale.
Yeah, not me, boy.
Look.
He was like, what you make here in 1 year, I made that in just this 1 hour.
Right. Shut up. I mean, no.
I mean, he's not wrong in that regard for what he's making, but there's also a reason why that is as well.
Right.
But we won't touch on that. That's not our place. To streamline it and be real, because I do enjoy like the dissecting of this situation.
Okay.
And again, we don't know yet. So let's leave the Udoka situation and just make it broader. like, what is it about cheating that's so fun?
Hey, yo, let me out the car. Let me out the car.
No, you in here now. I'm clank, not here. Clank. Nah. We're here. This, welcome to Oakland, bitch.
Hey, hey, suddenly I would like to leave your island.
And let me clarify. Allow me to expound, if you will. I, myself, as well as...
Emma Cheater, no.
As well as low gross Lauren here.
Hey, whoa, don't be telling nobody off here, dog. No. Use my government name.
All right.
That was a hit back from last.
Yeah. Yeah.
But,
bitch ass nigga.
But just to expound a little bit here. We are now reformed gentlemen. We are in happily committed relationships with black, strong black women.
Strong black woman. Strong black woman.
Strong black
woman. Beautiful black woman. Yeah.
But once upon a time, that was not always the case. And sometimes, you know.
No one knows what it means, but it's provided.
Oh, you know it.
It gets the people going.
Look, I think we've all done some dirt. We've all cheated. I think we've all been cheated on. It's just a part of life sometimes. But again, with that said, this is not regular, like relegated to some small, minute thing. This is just widespread, especially in office romances relationships. So again, I wanted to ask the question, why is cheating so fun?
These
niggas can't even help me. Like, I'm making millions of dollars.
This nigga E-Ray,
you don't need that coochie.
You like the, we not supposed to be having this sex.
Hey, ooh, nice. This is naughty. Like, whoa, why? I'll
say it for me, what happened in Toronto stays in Toronto.
Oh shit, it's hot up in the six, boy.
Right.
All
right. Right.
For the record, yeah. I have never cheated.
Oh yeah, you heard that story. You were a little bit.
Yeah, Smiles is a wild boy.
Yeah.
You took the chocolate sauce to Toronto?
I was with the ex-fiance at that time.
Well, we know why she's the ex-fiance.
She doesn't know about the story.
She didn't know. Now you know.
Right.
But as I was saying, I wanted to just kind of look at it because
I'm not here, bro. I'm producer low right now. I'm taking a step back. I'm not in this conversation. Go ahead.
I just want to know.
What year is this? Is the statute of limitations up?
Yeah, mad up. The thing is, these office relationships, people just having these secrets and stuff and just having a little bit of a thrill. It seems to be something that incites everybody. I was like, whether you've been in super long-term relationship or you've just been there for a couple, just getting to starting to know somebody. It's fun, but it's always enticing someone else because that's human nature. Human nature is just seems to be like, oh, we're like, I don't know how to explain it. So that's why I say I'm bringing it here to be like, why is it like this? Because it seems like even when you got all the money, because that was another thing that was stated prior to, it's like, oh yeah, because women be like, oh, the homosexuals, the niggas that ain't got nothing. So they bored, so they cheating. So like, but what, this nigga's rich.
Yeah.
And he's like, I don't care.
He got Nia Long.
I have Nia Long and I'm still gonna cheat.
But
I got Nia Long and I got the job and I'm still smashing.
So, Eric Benet cheated on Halle Berry, so that just means just because they
were
baddest.
Wait, he was a sex addict, though. That don't count.
Yeah, true. He just had to have it.
He a wild, wild boy.
Yeah. Well, like, what I'm saying is just because she's like we think of her, oh, that's Nia Long. He probably like, man, shut up, Nia.
I ain't going to say that lyric, but there's a lyric out there.
Short hair like Nia Long. That one?
Oh, no.
Oh.
What, much further back. It's like, for every beautiful woman, there's a nigga tired of fornicating with her. Let's say that. That's the thing. But women too. Women are not absolved from this. I think, like you said, the proximity of being around somebody, whether you like them or not. I've always heard that funny proverb that's like, oh, she's a worldly six, but she's an office eight.
What that mean? Just because in the environment of it's just like
if she's the best looking in the office.
There you go, Smiles. Because if you ain't like, you know, you like, oh, ain't no talent in this office. But this person that you like, oh, they're decent.
Yeah.
And you get to talk to them more. It is like you just start to build the chemistry. So again, women do this too. This is a whole thing. That's where the work husbands and all the bullshit comes from. But
you better not have no work wife. What you mean? You somebody's work husband?
Oh, Opal bury me sandwiches every day. She's just so friendly.
Don't be eating nobody else's sandwiches.
Right, nigga, munch.
Like, okay.
Like, babe, she said this at work. Oh, man, you should have heard what she said today. Oh, yeah, we did this. Oh, yeah, we went to lunch. Who's this bitch you going to lunch with and having all these conversations with?
Right, and that's the thing. The woman, she ain't saying none of that shit. She like, today was rough. You like, damn, what happened? You know, it was just rough. They ain't never like, oh, I went to lunch with Steve.
Yeah.
You ain't know about Steve.
We played footsies.
Right. Steve's in there packing her lunch.
Like, I know, like at my old job at the software company, man, the vice president and like one of the top sellers was ducked off. I was getting my lunch in the cafeteria. They was in the cafeteria, right? But they was ducked off in the little corner and stuff. And like they was just like you could just tell, you know, body language and stuff. It was too, you know what I'm saying?
Too familiar.
Yeah. That wasn't a let's get lunch and talk about Q4 like, plans. That was, hey, what you doing after this? You trying to. You know what I'm saying? Charles Lyons in the parking garage.
Like, hey, I had an old coworker just like that.
The stripper?
Him and a chick. I didn't even know that they was talking until one day he was like, hey bro, you know, want to come to the crib, watch the game? I'm like, all right, cool. So while we chilling there, knocking on my, like, oh, you buy someone else? I'm like, oh, he was like, yeah, nigga, don't say shit.
He should have told you that before you came over, though. Like, don't invite me into your mess. I'm an accomplice.
That's plausible deniability.
Yep.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Smilez, aka Hip Hop Adam Schefter, aka La Josh James, aka for all the ladies, the Chocolate Sauce Bandit. You already know what it is. Tune into an Audible Ruckus every week, and don't forget to check out my two shows at Shot vs. Smilez and Music Impulse on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple, SoundCloud, Amazon Music, whatever. Tune in. It's your boy Smilez, and I'm out.
Nobody seen nobody.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody.
But yeah, I mean, speaking to that same thing that Lo was just talking about, they now videos have surfaced after they won like the AFC, what is the fucking Eastern Conference Championship, that Udoka was walking through the thing and he like tunnel his arm like it was like, oh, is that too familiar? Now this is what we do. Revisionist history. We now go back and analyze
and look at it
and pick apart every little thing.
Instead of coaching in the timeout, he was looking up into the crowd like, hey girl, you still gonna suck this meat afterwards?
But they did that also Summer League. The other staffer that they was like, it could be originally, but they were thinking it was. They were looking at her and they were next to each other and they like slapping knees and stuff. And it always takes a different light. So we have no idea what's true and what's not. But it's basically like the whole media has been cheated on. Because again, if you've ever been in that situation, you're now looking back at every single thing you're analyzing. They're like, what the fuck was that?
Yeah.
Or vice versa. Yeah. If you've been doing some dirt, now other person looking at you, and you like, bitch, I just want some Cheetos.
Yeah.
Oh, that bitch wants some Cheetos at the store? Oh, she like Cheetos? Like,
hey, we saw on P-Valley, like, niggas will make an excuse to go to the store and just meet up at the store. Like, what? Mm-hmm.
So,
That's a thing.
Right.
Let's just walk around the aisles together.
So do y'all have any answers for me? I don't have no answers. You ain't got the answer, Sway?
Hey, come to find out.
Kanye said that Sway did have the answers.
Yes.
Hey. So we need to ask him. Sway, why is cheating so fun?
All right, so next time.
That's the name of the episode. Why is cheating so fun?
It's not the name of the episode.
Sway got this.
This ain't the Skeeters. You can put that shit. I'm making the Omar now. Why is cheating? I'm making big ass italic spot.
Well, so speaking of cheating, I couldn't wait to get to this.
Whoa, I bet. Never mind.
No, it's just Brett Favre.
The biggest cheater.
Yeah. Bitch Favre, aka pull my dick out Favre. You know what I'm saying? Pick Favre.
Mr. Creepy.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Creepy Pants.
Who used some
Wrangler jeans.
He did a lot of things. And
I have to cover this on the show, man, because first off, fuck Brett Favre. Right.
I was like, did you hate Brett
Favre? Right, yes, for sure.
Campaign?
Yes, for sure. Yeah. And so, and no, the inaudibles asked because they're like, why is no one covering? They was like, why is nobody covering Brett Favre? Why is this not getting the media attention that Michael Vick and Plaxico and all these other people got? And people were like, oh, well, it's because those was active players when it happened, Brett Favre. But I was like, nah, I'm not buying that. Like, he was a staple in the NFL. He was a face. He was a prominent player. Like, no, he got to get this same smoke. Mm-hmm. He got to get this same smoke. So what's going on is Brett Favre has been implicated. He's being sued by the state of Mississippi. He's being sued by the state of Mississippi because they're alleging that they misspent millions of dollars that were supposed to be allocated for welfare. So Favre, there's newly revealed text messages that indicate they're from 2017. They indicate that the former Mississippi governor, Phil Bryant, left office in 2020, was aware of an arrangement that there was money that was intended to help low-income families. But it was funneled through a nonprofit and eventually went to Brett Favre to help build a volleyball facility at the University of Southern Mississippi for his daughter's volleyball team. Now, I bring this up because this is why we're seeing pictures float around on Instagram of people in Jackson cutting on their water and brown water is coming out of the faucet. Brett Favre stealing from the people, man. What else is new?
Another case of, I mean, we're here now, so more cheating and robbing the people. Adam Levine, Maroon 5 fame, is now been outed from a supermodel. I think it's like Summer Stroh, some shit like that. Who cares? But apparently, she documented on TikTok that they had a year-long affair.
Damn.
And while he's married to a model or somebody or another, he's been on The Voice forever, you know, Adam Levine, Maroon 5, etc.
Mm-hmm.
But the text messages leaked of the conversation, he said he's had some inappropriate things, they led too far, but he didn't cheat. So again, he's married to a supermodel, talking to another supermodel, like, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
The leaks come out, he said, it went too far, I didn't have sex with her though. She says, This man hit her up after they ended their affair. Was like, you know what? He's like, my wife's having another baby. I want to name her whatever her name is. He's like, is that weird? And wow. She's like, I haven't talked to you in a year.
Damn.
So apparently he just let us know the box was fired.
Yeah.
So
right,
so good that I'm gonna name my daughter after you.
Right, so good right. I'm gonna name my son after you. That thing is wild.
But so hold on though, because I get the Adam Levine shit, but back to Brett Favre. Brett Favre, man, like this is all types of fucked up, man. And I want to know, like, what are they gonna do about it?
What's the solution?
Are they going to take the money back and give it where it was supposed to go? Like, what's going to happen here?
Yeah, because I know for me personally, when I read about it, I thought about, because I have a little cousin that got accepted to Jackson State University.
Okay.
Who actually left because of that whole water situation. She went back home to Chicago and all that shit. So when I heard that shit, I was like, see, this is that bullshit.
Yeah.
I mean, do we ever
know the ripple effect?
Do we ever know where the money's going of any of these charities? Because again, Black Lives Matter. So
right,
JJ Watt.
Lives Matter, but
yeah,
niggas was like, oh, we got money. Let's go throw a house mansion party.
We still,
my Black Lives Matters.
No, we still don't know where that Hurricane Harvey money went. JJ Watt said that he was going in the hood.
Joel Osteen's building fund for reinventing the church. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know where any of this stuff going. Again, like I said, cheating is fun in all forms and fashion. So it's just a thing now. So I don't know. I didn't make it up. I didn't make up the rules. I didn't make it up. I'm just telling y'all what it is. Joel Osteen, Brett Favre, Adam Levine, Ime Udoka.
What did Project Pat say? Ski mask on my face. Sometimes you gotta cheat to get ahead in this game quicker. Drink syrup like it's liquor. To chop a bang on you if you a blood or a cripple.
or like, hey, during games like Uno's, like, hey, if you don't catch me cheating, it's not my fault.
Smile said cheating is fun.
Hey, now here's the thing. Here's the thing. When I used to play pool, not in Detroit, because you can get killed for this shit, but like when I was used to play pool at the little summer program with the suburban like kids or whatever, when they wasn't looking and they just walking, I was down, like, I just grab a ball and just like grab a ball off. No. I would take them and put them in, like, just take them off the table and just do, and they'd be like, how you catch up so fast, man? Oh, it's crazy. He'd be like, yeah, I'm up. And they wasn't paying attention to this stuff. Like,
sick.
Hey.
That actually reminded me one time in BG when we lived at Enclave. Nene wanted to go in there and play.
To mention names, my nigga. Continue. But
no, this because she cheated. This is how she cheated me.
Somebody did this.
Oh, you gonna be on Front Street?
Somebody did
ask
this.
Ask her why cheating is fun. Ask.
So we in the you know how they had the pool table inside the little office area or whatever. So she's like, hey, you know, Smiles, you know, what place a pool? I'm like, oh, I really don't know a play, but whatever. She's like, I don't really know how to play either. So she's in there. We playing, and all of a sudden she like hitting like trick shots. Like she hit like a ball over another ball.
You know, between the legs. Like, God. That's my shot. Like, whoa.
She broke out Lucille.
Bring me
Lucille. I was like, damn, for someone who don't know how to play, you hitting these shots. So one of the officers were gonna come out like, oh, hey, see you in here playing pool again, Nina. You in here like almost every day. And I'm like, what? You just said you don't play at all. Smile. And she was like, I may play every now. I was like, damn.
Smile, that's not cheating. That's called getting hustled, my nigga.
She didn't cheat. Another form of cheating.
It's not. No, it's not. How is that cheating?
Look,
she told me she didn't play.
That's just a lie. That's not a cheat. A cheat is like you got to get an advantage. She didn't have an advantage. She just smoked your ass. Like that's all it was.
Literally the advantage. Nah. That he don't know how to play and she does. That's like, hey, my husband of 13 years. He's like, I'm home now after I was out with my girls. He's like, oh, but this nigga just texted you and said thanks for the slurp.
What up, though? It's your boy Lo Gross, also known as Big Papa Skeetor, and I'm here to let you know you just stepped into the Inaudiverse. That's right. We got four shows every week that we keeping y'all entertained with, man. We got the Music Impulse with Smiles. We got Bench Flicks and Chill with E Ray. We got Let Me Book the Territory with A Dub, J Mo, BA, and E Ray. Then we got the Skeeters Podcast with me and Neezy. And then we got the main show, the Inaudible Ruckus, man. So y'all just know we got y'all surrounded, man. Every day of the week, you're going to have some drops from us, man. We got music that we're working on, man. We got other shows that's in development, man. So it's just exciting times here at the Inaudible Ruckus Network, man. So y'all make sure y'all check out these shows, man. IR presents the Inaudiverse.
He was like, oh, I'm not cheating. I was with my girls. There's no advantage.
Now, earlier, you said shopping. Now tell me which one is it.
Just saying. It's all around us. It's just a thing. So, again, I asked the question. People love it. So, again, in everyday life, there's cheating of all types. It's not just extramarital affairs. Mm-hmm. It's cheating on your taxes. It's cheating out your companies.
Oh, yeah.
People love cheating. Cheating is fun.
Niggas like to cut the corners. Like to cut the corners.
And cut the help.
So.
Are we cutting?
Fantasy football, though, real quick. Smiles, how you doing? You alive over there?
What?
Not for long, man.
Yeah, so 0-2 in our league. You know, about to take on E-Ray this week.
About
to
go 0-3? You feeling confident? You gonna talk shit to him? Talk shit to this man. Don't let him come on the pod and punk you. Fuck him. He ain't nobody.
Right. I'm about to get this first W this week. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
What's the name of your team, Smiles?
Won't.
Shut the fuck up.
I can't even.
Just shut the fuck up.
I have so many random names I have for these stupid teams.
Called the Dallas Won'ts.
It was like probably some LeBron Bush. Oh yeah, the impulses. Right.
Yeah, I saw that. And then you tried to take my little logo emoji with the killer mask, like you was about to kill something, man. Y'all niggas ain't no killers.
Getting killed.
Oh, see, right. I don't ever care about them logos bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. So change it. Don't mock me, nigga. Like
you, don't mock me, mock TV.
Right.
You got all right, Jewel Lotana.
Right now. Yeah, it says look, yeah, projected 111 to 119, you know. So we gotta hope that, you know, the squad just come through and do a little bit more than what they projected.
Man, no, this is what you do. You go over to E-Ray's house and just act all cool, get him drunk, like have your drugs like that you always
whoa,
be having
Jeffrey.
Stuff.
Yeah. Relax, Dahmer.
And then when he passed out, you just take his phone and then you trade people to you from his phone. That's all you gotta do.
Right. Look,
sometimes you gotta cheat. That's it.
Yeah,
I'm trying to help you get ahead, Smiles. Damn.
Yeah, get Garoppolo out here. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, your see, man, Ma, that's how you get it.
I'm in St. Brown for Detroit. I need him to, you know, have a bad game after a great game after last week having. Because in my other league, I got the other wide receiver for Detroit, and this nigga had 0 points.
Who?
How the fuck?
I don't even know who the other wide receiver for Detroit is. So why'd
New
you
flash.
Pick him? Who, Chark?
No one does.
Who, yeah, Chark.
Why? Why'd you do that? Why? Why would you?
Because the week before, he had like a touchdown. He was like, oh, that means.
Don't ever. No. If you don't have Swift, yes, or Hockenson, or St.
Yeah,
Brown, don't get him.
Because I also got Hockenson, and that nigga had like 4 points.
Well,
because my guy is doing all the work.
Yeah.
Believe me, bet on Brown. That's what I'm talking about.
Equimini Brown.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sweetheart. My girl is also in the league, and I had to had to give it to her last week.
Daddy had to go to work.
had to give it to her. And, I won there, got my dub, and now I'm coming for Smiles too. He's next. He's next on the list. Got like a checklist, like clink. Get out of here while I'm still retooling, doing some things. And yeah, my other league, I'm 1-1 in both leagues. So things still happen. This has been a very weird start to the season.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, I don't even know. So much landscape shifting, and like we're in that weird.
It's gonna
time
be a long season.
Some of the goats are now falling off, and some of the new guys are starting to emerge.
But we got to see if we could trust the new guys or not. Because
which new guys you mean?
Right.
That's what it is. Gonna be.
So
not
like,
who.
like Gabriel Davis, he was projected, and we see this every year. It's always that
Buffalo
one breakout player.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. They always project that somebody's gonna break out and get him, and then you get him, but then you got to hold on to him because the first couple weeks he don't necessarily produce. Gabriel Davis jumped out the gate and was like, "All right, he one of those ones, right? So he's one of those ones we could trust for now, anyway." But like week four is when like the league really starts to like pan out, and then even there from week four to week eight is really like the where the separation really starts to like come to us. Cause I'm 2-0 in one league, and I'm 1-1 in another league. And the last league, like it looked like I wasn't gonna win. I started coming back, bro, and I ended up losing by 8 points. I'm proud of that.
Look,
I'm like the Lions, typical Detroit Lions fashion.
Look, that's all you need. It happened to the Browns. They should be 3-0 right now, and they are now 2-1.
Yeah.
So I'm not complaining. Just like you said with Gabe Davis. Rashard Bateman was another one of my sneaky picks. Mm-hmm. Hollywood Brown has moved on to Arizona. So Ravens had lost like a main guy to throw it to. And I don't trust Dobson yet as far as a running back for Lamar Jackson. So Bateman has to catch all the targets that Hollywood Brown and that Mark Andrews don't get. So I was like, I've been pretty right. He's doing great for the first like 2 weeks. So let's see if he keeps that up. I would love to see it because I'm just thinking logically. Josh Allen doing fantastic. I don't know how much he'll hold up, but he's a big corn-fed white boy. So I'm hoping.
The white Cam Newton with a better arm.
Yeah, yeah. He's better. A lot better things.
I'm just talking about where his running and just his non-stop running either. Yeah. Like he running. He don't slide or nothing. He just.
Nah. And that's what I'm worried about. I'm like, hey, I remember RG3. Chill. Yeah.
Well, what I gather, this is why I like
the
Josh
same way
Allen,
about
though.
Lamar Jackson. I'm like, I want you to run, but don't be running 70 yards, my nigga.
Oh, no. Lamar Jackson will run 70 yards. Then he's sliding.
Yeah.
But what's the name? Just be
Allen,
taking some hits.
Yeah, Allen don't give a fuck, though. He like, look, I've been fighting my whole life to make it to the league. I will die out here.
Right.
He was like, no, for real. He's like, I'm willing to die for this shit. And you'd be like, bro, you don't have to. Like, you're good. You
he remind me of Omar Epps and Ian Too Deep. Like, bro, it's okay.
Yeah. You ain't no cop, Josh Allen.
Like, this is going to be wild. So yeah. Like, you don't have to do that. But he's trying to prove that he's the guy. And so far, they're doing great. Plus, yeah. I got the defense. But yeah, it's fun football season so far. I love that football's back. Yes. I can't get enough of it. The Dallas Cowboys got a surprising victory.
That
was interesting fun. Because I guess I knew not to get Dak. So let's put it there. Mm-hmm. I knew better, but this year I was like, I gotta give me some black quarterbacks. I mean, Josh Allen's honorary black quarterback.
Yeah, for sure.
And
for sure.
And then Kyler Murray, I picked him up. They've had a weird kind of rough start, but he's still getting his points. So I'm like,
At this point, it's like, hey, whether they win or not, get the points. Throw for 400 yards, and if you lose, that ain't my problem because that's not my team.
Right. Ain't my team, dog.
Not me, boy. So I will have to say this.
Right.
Shout out.
My roommate, he just did a draft for the NBA.
Oh yeah, I don't play fantasy NBA because that's a whole nother thing. And if all it takes is 1 or 2 weeks to get behind, you'll never catch back up, and you just lose.
That's too many niggas that I don't care about.
Yeah, that's what
I don't give a shit.
Because I had to explain to him, like, he was like, yeah, so do I get points for, like, if my team wins? I was like, nah. I was like,
no.
That don't mean nothing. He was like, oh, what? And I was like, yeah. I was like, as long as that nigga get his points and his rebounds or whatever the fuck, that's all you care about.
So I do want to shout out the Lions because I've been critical of them, and I'm like, they got the type of win that I wanted to see from them, even though it was against the Washington, whatever, the no names.
The Commanders with Carson Wentz throwing for 4 billion yards.
Yeah.
Were right. So I'm gonna give you some shit, but before I do, I'm going to say particularly, you were right. That defense is non-existent.
Mm-hmm.
But.
Except for Hutch.
I mean,
you gotta
he can't do it all.
Right.
they could run him around everywhere because it's like, all right, cool. It don't matter because they're still putting up points. But you said the pieces don't matter. And those pieces have been slowly grinding, which is Swift.
Hold on. I didn't say they didn't matter. I just said that they have to be consistent. And they got to actually do some shit with it. I'm talking,
but
I know what I said. I wasn't sold on them, and I did say Swift was a piece. Hawkinson, all the niggas that we named,
like, the pieces don't matter when so. And I was like, you're
they
right.
Still don't matter in the bigger scheme of things. This is one win. They could go 1-16 for the rest of the season, my nigga. I'm just giving them credit on this one win. I'm not about to say all Lions to the Super Bowl or Lions to the playoffs.
I'm not at all. But okay. I'm just saying.
Just making sure. I'm not overreacting.
But,
I'm just, again, I'm willing to admit.
You also gave Hollywood
Brown.
You gave Amon-Ra St. Brown a lot of shit. Like, this man, blah, 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 blah.
Yes.
He's a star. He's the guy.
Okay.
The guy.
And? We had the best wide, arguably one of the best wide receivers in the history of the game, and he didn't do shit. So this nigga won one game.
Hey, his fault.
Hey, yes, he did. Matthew Stafford, that's the only person he threw the ball to.
Right, that was the only target. Yeah,
but he couldn't get it to him when it counted.
Yes, he could. What you mean? That's all he did.
They would have beat Dallas.
They did beat Dallas. Not that one game, but the other game when he threw that Hail Mary, he threw it over 3 Cowboys. It was like 15 Cowboys covering Calvin Johnson. He jumped up and caught it. Like, he going to get the ball to him.
The one where he caught the ball and then touched it on the ground, and it was like, that's not a touchdown.
That was against the Browns. That shit made me so – I'm not the Browns, the Bears. That shit made me so – I broke my couch that day, literally. You can ask my cousin. I almost kicked the TV over, and I didn't, but I jumped on the couch, and the couch broke.
Yo, it's E Ray, the quasi bad guy, the Diet Coke of evil, the side god of pod. And I'm here to tell y'all, come check out my show, Binge Flicks and Chill. You never know what you're going to get, but we always talking some good shit when it comes to television and the latest movies. So we want to bring y'all in. We want to make sure you have a good time. You learn something, you laugh, you cry, you might stab a nigga or two. I don't know what you're going to get, but that shit is popping. So come check out Binge Flicks and Chill. And it's me, E Ray, and I'm out.
Oh, shit.
Like, no, he's lying. He's being modest.
No, I'm
this
not.
This nigga picked up the couch and just shredded
incredible
it in
gross.
Half.
Bruh, I was so pissed. But that's what I'm saying. So yes, I will give you. They produced last week. I need to see that type of stuff at least through a stretch to make us competitive. If we go 9-7 playing that way, cool. But we still ain't gonna like. But like I can
see somewhere around there between 7-7
I don't know
because it's 17 games, right? So it's like 7-10 or something.
Yeah, yeah. I keep saying like between 16.
Yeah, 7-10 and 9-8
Yeah,
whatever. It's gonna be somewhere around there. I can see, but their defense has to be addressed, and then they will. They can get there. Right now, it's still iffy. I still think about 6 games is probably right for them.
And here's why. Here's why. When the division is turning, like how it is this year, you got to be able to strike and take advantage. And I have not seen the Detroit Lions be in a position to do that because Green Bay is not operating on all cylinders. The Vikings is always kind of up and down. The Bears ain't got it. Not yet anyway, right? The Bears are still trying to figure it out.
They got pieces too, but they're still trying to figure it out.
Yep.
But look, I know this better than anybody because, again, this is the Brown shit every year. Steelers looking very faulty. The Ravens were having a down season. Then here comes the fucking Cincinnati Bengals out of nowhere to the Super Bowl.
Yep.
And it's like,
how sway?
The Browns, this was there, and they did. So even still, like right now, they don't look like they're going to do it. So it's like maybe next year, hopefully, possibly, or if Jacoby Brissett can keep them into contention for.
Because this ain't even their final form.
Deshaun Watson
come back, like. Y'all going to the Super Bowl this year.
Right.
Like that would be more games or some shit like that.
But No, they got he got 11 games.
All right. So before we head out, we gearing up because Bench Flicks and Chill is coming back.
Yeah.
E Ray, I know you've been catching up on some series. Now, do you have any recommendations?
Yeah, man. I got a few. What I've been doing in this off time for Binge Flicks is literally just watching as much shit as I possibly can. Because everything ain't going to be for everybody and everything is not going to make the show. But I just like watching TV because it's so many things that could be good. This week, I caught two new premieres. One, Cyberpunk 2027, or 2077, excuse me. It's an animated show on Netflix. It's part of, I guess, a Netflix original animation called Cyberpunk 2077 Edge Runners. Shit was lit. I was like, I heard the game came out maybe a year or two ago.
Mm-hmm.
The game had a lot of issues. It was big hype because of Keanu Reeves was supposed to be this big heaping guy, blah, 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 blah. And this crazy world. Well, the game failed miserably. But sometimes out of a piece of shit, you can get some greatness.
You can fertilize the lawn.
Facts. And this shit right here, I was like, oh, this is entertaining as hell. I almost stayed up all night watching the whole series because it's basically a young Hispanic kid in like a new cyber metropolis, and everything is ran by tech. So it's kind of going like, you know, with the new house and stuff like that. It's like smart houses on a trillion because dude couldn't even finish washing his clothes because mom didn't pay the thing. So it's just like, oh, please insert more credits. And it's like, damn, my fucking school uniform is off. He got to pay like for his Oculus goggle input, which costs more money. Mm-hmm. He got the old school joint. Everybody else got the new shit in his preppy school. Everybody got like slots in their neck to they can upload shit kind of like the Matrix.
Mm.
So I was like, that's really cool, but
that's where we're heading. Everybody's gonna turn themselves to an NFT.
That's what I'm like.
Metaverse.
So essentially what happens is something happens with his family situation and he turns into like this life of being an edge runner, which is basically people who kind of do odd jobs for money, but they also have cyber enhancements. So he wanted dude like got his ass beat and he was like, there's this enhancement at his house. He put it on, like they replaced his spine with this robotic spine shit. And this made this nigga super fast. And he start robbing people off the bank, beating the shit out of this dude.
Damn.
But the catch is, in this cyber world, everybody is having, like, if you get too much cybernetics done to you or you overly use it, you become called a cyber freak. So like, you're basically, your mind is just gone. Yeah, so you're just like spacing out and you got all this tech, so you be killing people on accident, and then these people come in and basically murder you. So it's just evolving. You're watching this dude's journey from like a younger kid to now I'm at the point where he done upgraded his body and all this shit. This nigga like Jack now. This shit's raw. So I can't recommend enough for people who like anime, people who like animation, yep, or just like something different than the normal.
I added it while you were talking. I was like, let me add this.
Cyberpunk 2077 Edge Runners. Dope. Also, Netflix hit us with Monster, or the Jeffrey Dahmer story. Done by Ryan Murphy, the same dude who does all of the what the hell is that? The Murder House and the was it Scary? Not Scary Stories.
Scare Straight.
The nigga Smile says Scare Straight though. No, the damn, what is the show called? He does all the shows with the damn, I cannot think of what it's called. Either regardless, he does all the new scary series, like American Horror Story. Oh, okay. Smile says Scare Straight. I still can't get over that. But yes, he produced this show called The Jeffrey Dahmer Story, and it literally is, I don't know how many episodes thus far, I think I'm on episode 6, but it goes into Jeffrey Dahmer basically within from 66 to 91 ish when he got caught, which is about this serial killer who's a ragingly homosexual man that is murdering other homosexuals and eating them, and like the way he lures them in and all this shit. Like, that's not the wild part. The him being a murderer and all this other stuff isn't the wild part. The wild part is watching this white man be able to do this within the society because of white privilege, because of like police discrimination in black neighborhoods and under policing and all the other things about it, and like even how the courts play into allowing a predator to stay on the or out of the prisons, while, you know, because they see themselves in him because he's white. So it's wild, but it's a really well done show. One of the main characters, the dude who's playing Jeffrey Dahmer, I forget his name, but he's from the American Horror Story franchise.
Okay.
He definitely has like that Dahmer thing down, because they've been a million different types of documentaries on Jeffrey Dahmer, but to kind of watch this stuff play out, because the dude was sick.
Because he was like the original, like Hannibal Lecter, like in real life. He was like going around eating folks.
Mm. Yeah, to a degree. It was like basically, we didn't know anything. We were like, wait, what? And then just more and more stuff came out. But he basically targeted a bunch of gay people from like gay clubs, mm-hmm, and stuff like that. And then it started to go into deeper, like him being in his family's house and him like having these illnesses where his mom was like mentally ill, and they blamed what they thought could have been something with him, like, mm-hmm, he had pneumonia as a child, blah blah blah, and he was taking this pill so it might have messed him up. But he's like, no, I was born this way. I like men, but I like to like murder them and do that.
I like, whoa, men, yeah, I like to murder them.
like dude, and it's not even like,
means. No one knows what it means, but it's provocative.
No, it's not. Nice.
It gets the people going.
Yeah, it gets him going, because he's like, hey, he basically just drug people and like strangled them while they were unconscious and killed them, then like carved, yeah, their body up, ate them, or preserved them, did experiments on them. Dude was wild, but it's, wow, a wildly interesting watch. It tells you a lot about like just crazy people and enablers. So the people around the people. That's why I said, look, if you come from me, whether you my child, my family, anybody, if you do some wild, weird shit, I don't give a fuck. I have no allegiance to you. Now, you weird and wild. You're done. I'm not gonna be, oh, that's my baby though. That nigga eating people.
What happened to unconditional love?
I cheated on it.
Right.
He stepped out on it.
Look, it is what it is. You can love somebody unconditionally, but you also don't have to enable their issues.
Yeah,
let's say.
That's true.
But it's a good watch, I would say. I'm going to finish that up probably sometime this weekend, but I recommend that as well. Those are going to be the E Ray picks of the week and probably things that we will talk about more on Binge Flicks, along with Atlanta's final season is back. I have not watched it yet because I want to wait. I want to save it all, but I'm hearing good things about it. People who were not necessarily on board are back on board.
I'll say this. They're giving me what I asked for and what we talked about on our episode of Binge Flicks, where it's like, do the weird shit, but do it through the characters. And that's it. Like I said, take us to another level, but like, I want to see them do it. Don't segue over to this other person or this or that. So that's what's happening. And so far, we 3 episodes in? I'm okay. I'm cool. I am satisfied.
Well, hey, maybe niggas do like high art. They cheat on it. I don't know.
There you go. Before we slide, Smiles, we doing something different this week, y'all. Going forward, Smiles, you got some songs for us? What's these next songs?
All right, so the first song we got is my guy Jay Smith featuring an artist named K Shakur with Guy Like Me. This track is kind of like a response to the Girl Like Me that Jasmine Sullivan dropped off her latest album. So that's kind of like his response to her. And then this other song, you know, I'm proud to say I made the connection, executive producer A&R Smiles.
Let's go.
With my guy Swole the Bagga, produced by my guy Dennis, which E-Ray, you met. He was the one that hosted Urban Trivia. He produced this track. So, yeah, this is Swole the Bagga, produced by Shot by Dan with Deliah, A&R by your boy Smiles.
That's what I'm talking about.
Nice.
All right.
Nice.
Y'all know what it is, man. It's an Audible Ruckus. Motherfucker.
Eat your food. Don't have sex with it.
Rich ass nigga. Yeah. Look. See the world, it don't love a nigga. It only gives you one shot, so let me focus when I pull the trigger. Cause honestly, I always wanted more. Wish I could take it back to when P had speakers on all of his doors. Was out here fucking these whores and really keeping the score. How childish, how immature. Live life's I counted for. You lying, I'm in the roar. I'm lying, you in the roar. Anita singing sweet love, that's why I'm in it for. Damn near fucked every girl that I knew wanted to change for you. Call it quits, get my name to you. Losing you, that's insane to do. And do I look insane to you? I wanted to be so fresh, so clean, but I know I left a stain or two. All this trauma, little mama, shit, how do I explain to you? I'm self-taught, that can explain all the negative self-talk. It's heaven in my heart with so many of these hell thoughts. I'm demonized, I need your angel eyes to help me minimize what I feel inside. My pops was just rushed to emergency and almost died. Cried like a baby, felt alone on this journey ride. Let's get high in this motherfucker, cause you heard me, right? And you promised not to desert me, right? Please reassure all the insecure. I smoke flower, roll leaf, so everything is pure. I'm making money, they still making sure. They gon' watch me in case I hit the floor. Fuck these niggas, they can't fuck with me. It can get ugly, I know you never seen inside of me. Please pray for me when you see the devil come out of me. My homie say he saw your profound Tinder. Now I'm all up in my feelings, posting Drake lyrics on Twitter. Whatever I asked, you would've just given. Your skin so Cleveland brown, I'm getting used to this winning. I was up 20 points with you and didn't know I was winning. I should've chose you, I know, and now part of me missing. You solid, took away from you and still nothing is missing. On 4 of your lips, I should be kissing. The tongue is a machine gun, unlimited ammunition. I hope I didn't make you change, your mama raised you Christian. You wanna be a stripper? Well, I'll go be T-Pain 2 degrees, but I'm still speaking all of this street slang. You should be on the throne at the top, so your feet hang. You said you'll love me through it all, baby, you said we gang. I should be deep in your core instead of breaking your core. I should be bringing you peace instead of bringing you war. You should be wearing the crown, I should be holding you down. I should be holding you now. I wanna love you just how you need, just show me how. I hear the hurt, I know it's more than music, but you ain't have to bring her into it. Yeah, but this one on me, I know. Please say it ain't so. It's gon' crush me to find out I made you a hoe.
Yeah, you gon' make me a gold digger. Maybe I should look like a stripper. Wearing fashion over dresses. All these dudes be pressing, impressed with it. You leave me with no choice. Oh, I can't do this good girl shit no more. Oh, I just wanted something different. Still don't know what I was missing.
It's your boy Uncle Skeetar, and you are listening to Inaudible Ruckus. Make sure you check us out on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, and SoundCloud, and check out the website, inaudibleruckus.com. It's Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker.
Through all trials, I'm all smiles, you hear me? Good money go broke.
Knowing shorty lying, she ain't think I knew though. Why he ain't got time? This watch from my new hoe. Back on my grind, ain't nothing new though. Asking how I shine till the clutch just got a new look. Gotta see me buy a permit like the dentist room.
Now we bossing.
Got receipts to show I paid the cost and plenty to do.
Now we mossing.
Bought a flip for wedding cake off there for 22.
Oh, you crossed me.
And you leave me there, and now I gotta send it. Life. Death before the son of Frida wants to send in kites. Bandages across my back, you stab me with a knife. Managed to get out the grass before the snake could bite. Need someone to bitch and sew that bitch back. Hey, bitch, get a dike. I peep they Insta reels, these niggas real in disguise. Eventually, my chill will make its way back from the skies. New bitch I roll with, she set the bar, I'm talking dice. I mean, who the fuck gon' leave go money, Mitch for Uncle Ice?
Go money or go broke.
Hey, tell it all again.
Go money or go broke.
What they yelling
what
at?
They
go money or go broke.
Catch yourself, get in the wind.
Go money or go broke.
Coulda leveled you.
Should be stepping out the beans. Would've blessed one of your pots, but I ain't wanna fuck your friend. Was the lesson in the blessing? I hope flexing out of sin. Cause suppressing this depression took my heart away like 10. But man say, knowing shorty lying, she ain't think I knew though. Why he ain't got time? This watch from my new hoe. Back on my grind, ain't nothing new though. Asking how I shine till the clutch just got a new. Gotta see me buy a permit like the dentist room.
Now we bossing.
Got receipts to show I paid the cost and plenty do.
Now we mossing.
Bought a plate for wedding cake off there for 22.
Now you cross me.
Yeah, you did me that, and now I gotta send it shoot
to death.
Hey, you must think I'm stuck on stupid SOS. Come help me help you, can't help no one that don't want to help they self. Jugging meant to say I'm dealing with the cards I'm dealt. Ay, wouldn't say you feel me if you know how this shit felt. Ay, couldn't say I'm healing cause I'm building back my health. Thought we was the business, had my heart all on the shelf. Ay, thought you knew my business, bitch, that info all on yep. Yep, yep, yep. It's gold money or gold broke.
I'm one of a kind.
Gold money or gold broke.
Summertime with time.
Gold money or gold broke.
Fighting from behind.
Gold money or gold broke.
Come and clean a bunch of irons.
Come with me, jump the line. Onion on the back, my new Levi. Got a country fine. Hit on my top, wasted my time. Shit, that's 100 crimes. Play yourself, cause money talks. Since we don't talk, now you mind me, little bitch.
Shout out to Jehovah.
This has been another episode of the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. Make sure you subscribe on Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud, Stitcher, Pocket Cast, everywhere where podcasts are. You can also find us on iHeartRadio app. Also go to the website, inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Make sure you go to our YouTube page, subscribe there. Make sure you go to midnightclubmerch.com. Also support Naturally Nay. Make sure you subscribe to her YouTube channel. Also, you can purchase her products on the Inaudible Ruckus website. Okay, we got the Naturally Nay Moisturizer Dual. It's rated E for everybody. So, women, it works for your natural hair. If you're trying to, like, grow out your froze, get your locks and everything going. Fellas, it works for your locks and beards as well, too, right? So, it works for everybody, right? We even using some of it on London, Baby London, and it's growing her hair, too. So, just something to consider there. But it's time to get up out of here, man. And like my OGs used to tell me, go with God and fuck the rest. It's an Audible Ruckus. Motherfucker.
Now my shit be booming all across the Atlas. Across the Atlas. Across the Atlas. Across the Atlas.